Welcome to Breaking News Today YouTube channel. Please subscribe and don't forget to press the bell icon button to get daily latest news alert. Click on the CC button to get automatic subtitle in video if you're facing the difficulties in listening sound. For decades, there was a ceiling not of glass but of ice, for women in science, the continent of Antarctica. The heroic tradition of polar exploration conducted solely by men meant that Antarctica itself was often thought of as a woman to be conquered. U.S. Navy Admiral Richard Byrd described it as an enchanted continent in the sky, pale like a sleeping princess. Women were not permitted a role in this age of adventure. But not for lack of trying. Sir Ernest Shackleton refused the request of three sporty girls who wrote to him in 1914. Seeking a place in his Imperial Transantarctic Expedition because they, did, not see why men should have all the glory, and women none. There is also evidence, says Antarctic historian Morgan Sieg, that 1,300 women applied to join a proposed British expedition in 1937. All were denied, she tells 100 women. Russian geologist Maria Klenova was the first woman to conduct research in the Antarctic, in 1956. Argentine scientists followed a decade later. But some countries were slower to thaw, with the US and UK only reversing their formal bans in the late 1960s and 70s. The apparent moral peril of mixed accommodation was one argument against including women. Janet Thompson, the first woman to go south with the British Antarctic Survey, BAS, had to informally convince the wives of her teammates that she was going as a serious scientist, Sieg explains. Another application was turned down by BAS as there were no facilities for women in the Antarctic. No shops. No hairdressers. Unsurprisingly, tenacity is a common theme amongst early female polar scientists. Geologist Sudipta Sengupta tells 100 women that she wrote to India's Department of Ocean Development in 1982 declaring her interest in the country's second Antarctic expedition. A year later, she and marine biologist Aditi Pant became the first Indian women to set foot on the continent. The team's mission was to set up India's first station in Antarctica, Dakshin Gangotri. Sengupta remembers having to fight the idea that she was an ornamental part of the expedition team. I assumed all kinds of responsibilities, both scientific and tasks that required physical labor. You have to consider yourself equally capable as a man in everything you do, she recalls. Meanwhile in Germany, Dr. Monica Puskep-Elliott was fighting a similar battle. Fascinated by the medical challenges of overwintering in the Antarctic, where brutal weather isolates teams from civilization for up to 9 months, she first began appealing to Germany's Polar Research Institute in 1984. Puskep-Elliott's campaign attracted letters from other German women, mostly scientists, keen to take part. But resistance was strong. They didn't want to have mixed teams on an Antarctic base, she explains to 100 women. I was told. This is not possible for women in this century. Ironically, the eventual compromise turned out to be more groundbreaking than Puskep-Elliott anticipated.